Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and today I wanted to do a haul of my recent things that I have bought, and an update on my low buy. Okay, I have failed miserably the first 2 months of the year. I have continued to buy, although I have to say it is much more conscious than just randomly buying things. I remember I used to just go and buy stuff for the sake of it, just because I am outside. Whereas nowadays, I definitely always have a list with me of the things that are on my wish list that I wanna find, I wanna get. Things have shifted a little bit because I used to always just buy casual clothing and, you know, whatever else. But because I am now back to working in a corporate environment, I am now more focused on purchasing work wear, like suits, work trousers, work skirts, work dresses, and stuff like that, that I can actually wear to work. Now, I would be lying if I said that I do not have enough clothes to wear to work, because I do. Like, I could have 3 full weeks without repeating an outfit. That's how much workwear I have. And in my inventory, I used to have 230 items. Now I have 239. That still includes like my loungewear, my sleepwear, my activewear, my scarves, all my bags, my shoes. Okay, it's all there. I have also in the process started letting go of things that I don't use. I either sell them. I've swapped a few things from a swap drop with that was organized by Style X Ministry on Instagram. And in that swap, there's actually already 2 things that I had donated already. Because when I swapped them, I thought it was going to be great. But actually, when it got to me, I was not that impressed. One of them is a Trent Nathan bag that I thought was going to be a nice bucket bag, but it was more of a tote, so I didn't keep that. I just actually went and donated it. And then I got a pair of ballet flats, the ones that got the elastics at the back. So for one, it was really painful, and two, the quality was poorly made, which is very surprising of ballet, to be honest. Because the sole was coming off unglued, but it looks like it has never been worn, like even if you check the soles. So today I just let that go, and I went to Salvo's and donated that. I also bought a sort of like a light pink satin cami. It's not actually satin, I think it's polyester, from, is it Fabric Portraits? I think it is. From Instagram, I bought it for $5, but it was cut too low that it was basically just covering my nips, and that's not really how I intended to wear it. I thought it was gonna be a good cami for underneath the blazer for when I go to work, but I obviously can't wear that to work because it was just too low. Yeah, so there were a few things that I had already donated, and there was one thing that I actually received. It was, the leather of the bag was still in good condition. It's a Givenchy bag, okay, from when they still had their old logo of the 4Gs together. Anyway, I got that. It was in tan, but there was a lot of discoloration. There was stains and color transfer. And the original owner, the swapper, said that she's had it for a couple of years, but she hasn't really used it, and that's why it's got that discoloration. So I went ahead and refurbed that bag. I'll show you what it looks like, the before, and I will show you now what it looks like now that I have refurbished it. Okay, so this is what the bag looks like now. So before I painted acrylic leather paint on here, I actually dyed it first with the same color. So this center part here and the back are in navy. I dyed it navy and then painted leather acrylic paint on it in navy as well. And then the handles and the trimmings here are black. They're jet black. Again, dyed it first and then added on top of it the acrylic paint, and then on the sides I left it as English tan. So again, dyed it first and then doubled it up with the actual acrylic paint. I left the insides of it in its original state. I didn't want to touch that part, but it's still quite a beautiful leather. It's got fabric lining. Givenchy, made in Italy, and it has this, hope you can see that. I don't know if you can. Yeah, but that's the serial number of it. So I was inspired by my Loewe bag that was navy with black handles, so that's why I decided this. People always tell me all navy and black shouldn't go together, but rules are made to be broken. I don't know who even made up that rule, but anyway, here it is. How beautiful is that? Anyway, okay, so moving on to the purchases that I have recently made. This one here is a purchase from the Sydney Suitcase Rummage that I went to last week, the 23rd of February. So this is a beautiful navy skirt that has sort of like a velvet feel on here. Kind of suede, suede pockets. I haven't worn this yet, so I don't really have a picture of me wearing it. But I love that the buttons are in the front, and I feel like it's going to be a cool skirt to wear. Especially now that it's autumn. So I feel that navy, apart from the usual gray, beige, maroon, little darker shades, is appropriate for winter. Now this is what's the brand of this? It's a Witchery size 10 skirt, and it has never been worn. In fact, it still had the tag when I bought it. I just took it off because I put it in the wash and I didn't want to wash the tag. But it has never been worn by the original owner. So, and I bought it for $10, and this thing's usually would be at least $80. Okay, so that's one there. Now there is also another a pair of shoes that I got. It's Stuart Weitzman. Pair of black pumps by Stuart Weitzman, and the owner had used it when she was working corporate, but now she's not working corporate anymore, so she was selling it and she sold it to me for $10. Gonna insert a picture here. I bought it the moment I saw it, I was like, ooh, Stuart Weitzman. And then I looked at the size, it was 36.5, and I was like a little bit doubtful because I'm usually a 37, but I tried it on and it fit perfectly. I don't have it with me right now because it's in the office, because I use it to work. Okay, while we're talking about shoes, I'm not sure if I've actually already shown this to you guys, but I also got these pointed Diana Ferrari red. On camera, it looks really bright red, but it's more of a Merlot in real life. It's much more scarlet than Merlot. Pure leather upper, non-leather lining, and sole made in China. This is a 7.5, but it fits me perfectly. I usually wear a gel pad underneath it, inside, just to soften it, because I'm not really used to wearing heels, but because I'm back in corporate, I kind of have to. Here's another pair of shoes I got from eBay. With eBay, I think I paid $15 for this. The Diana Ferrari shoes were $15, but there was 20% off at Salvo's, so it came down to $12, and it was unused. The same with this pair of New Balance 574s. I've been looking for these, and I love that I got them in the color that I'm looking for, which is gray and black. Paid $15 plus shipping. It came in its original box and everything like that, so very, very chuffed with that. It is a teeny tiny bit small. It's actually just right, but if I wore thicker socks, it would be a little bit more difficult to wear it, to walk in it, but it's just the perfect size. And one second, there was one other thing that I'm not sure if I've already talked to you guys about, but it's another Witchery item. It is this beautiful dark navy blazer that is very Balmain-esque, double-breasted with beautiful gold, oh no, this ones are silver buttons. You can see it there. you can see it there. I need to restitch the buttons on this one because it's there. Some of them are coming loose and I don't really want to lose them. This is again by Witchery. I paid, how much did I pay? $70. This was expensive. But this blazers go, I think, $300-something. So $70, including shipping. Okay, including shipping was a pretty good deal. So she was selling it for $60. I got this from the Facebook Marketplace. Very rarely worn, actually. And there's one more that I am planning to buy. It's a white one. It's by Portman's. It's a white one with gold blazer buttons, but I haven't pulled the trigger on that one just yet because I don't know. I think I have too many blazers already. But yeah, so this is navy. This is navy. They might actually go well together. They're from the same brand, but this is a much darker navy. This is just normal navy. Anyway, moving on to what I purchased today. I went to Chatswood to meet a friend of mine and donated that Trent Nathan bag and that Bali shoes and that satin cami and another blazer. I went to donate that, so I went to Salvo's. And there's something about tweed blazers and tweed jackets that I have been obsessing over. You would have seen, if you follow me on Instagram, that I bought one that's very vintage and it had like purple and silver and cream on it. Well, this one I found today for $15. This is by Mango. And I'm gonna insert some pictures of me wearing it, as how I would style it. But this is something that I could totally wear to work and also wear on a more casual basis. So this is a beautiful, beautiful. It's got shoulder paddings. Obviously, I'm gonna need to throw this in the wash first before I would wear it out, but it is beautiful. There's no pulls or snags. So when I put this kinds of things into the wash, I always put them in a laundry mesh bag so that they don't, if there's anything that might pull onto them with other clothing, there is less likelihood that that's gonna happen. I love the details. Like look at the sleeves on this. Look at the pockets. Yeah. So that's actually what drew me to this, and it's just gorgeous. And also one of the reasons why I haven't pulled the trigger on that white double-breasted jacket is because I keep thinking I will find it in the off shops, but I haven't really. I've always also been looking for pleated black skirt. I've got something like this in a sort of like a burnt orange, almost bronze shade, and one that's more of a light pink. I wanted a black one, so I could use it to work. This needs a little bit of washing because I can see there's like a white spot right there. I don't know if you can actually see it, but there's a white spot there in the skirt, somewhere here. So obviously this is going to go into the wash, but again, I'm putting up a picture somewhere here to show you how I would wear this. Again, it can be worn more formal for the office or more casual for every day. So that one is, by the way, by the brand Meredith and More Melbourne. So this is in size 12 and it is Australia made. Okay, so here's a pair of like normal, average office trousers with like straight leg, because the one that I have that I use for work, I like that because it is elasticated at the waist, but it's tapered. So it's got that very distinctive look. I wanted something that's a little bit more loose and open on the legs. So I found this. This is by M&S Collection. So obviously this is from the UK because we don't have Marks and Spencer's here in Australia. Not that I'm aware of. Let me know if I'm wrong. This is a UK size 10 or a European 38. And it's long. It says UK long, but it's just right for me. I don't know if the owner had it altered. It doesn't look like it is, but yeah. I tried this on, thought it would be a good alternate to that black trousers that I own. It's much more office looking. And when I buy secondhand trousers, I always check the crotch area that there's not too much chafing going on there and rubbing, that it has, that the fabric has thinned and it's going to break soon enough. So this one is in really good condition. And I paid $13 for this trousers. The skirt was $12, so that's $25. Oh no, the skirt was $10. So that's 13. This one was $15. So what's that? 13, 23, 15, 38. Okay, that's right. Because the next item is actually a pair of a full suit with blazer and trousers, and it was for $22. And I really like this because it fits perfectly. Like this trousers, and I'm pretty sure that this was altered because you can see here that it was made to be tighter. So I'm probably going to undo that and make it a little bit looser because it's a little bit too tight around me. I just need maybe half an inch more to make it more comfortable, but otherwise it sits really nicely around my waist. And I believe that this has been made shorter. They even have, it looks like it's been made shorter because there's some like alteration markings at the hems, but it's made shorter, which is perfect for me because this is a men's suit. Okay, and usually with men's suits they're quite long on me, but this one's already been altered. And the corresponding jacket to that, and I did not even realize this, I just saw it now. I don't know if you saw it, if it registered on camera, the look on my face. This jacket here, okay, it says here, Trabaldo Togna, 1840, woven in Italy. And I only looked at this side of the garment while it was hanging. I did not, for the life of me, notice that on this side it said Hugo Boss. So my suit is a Hugo Boss suit. There's something in this pocket. I think it might be a pocket square or tissue. Oh, it's a white pocket square that is dirty. I'm just gonna take that off because you can see like detergent had, or maybe I won't take it off. I will go ahead and wash it with this, and if it doesn't wash off, then I will take it off. But I have a Hugo Boss suit. Why didn't I notice that? Because I didn't even take a look at the tags here. I just went ahead and tried it on. Yeah, Hugo Boss. $22, Hugo Boss. Anyway, okay, that is my haul for today. I spent $60 in salvos, got a full suit, trousers, skirt, and another jacket. I have an upcoming, I'm waiting for the delivery from eBay, but I have a tweed jacket, double breasted, that's coming, that's black and white. I might pull the trigger on that white blazer as well. And if you follow me on Instagram, you would see there how I style these clothings, how I wear them, and how often I re-wear them. And I also just last week, I didn't have a video on here, but I did have an IGTV where I took you guys to the Kiribilli. Well, the Insta stories and highlights, I've got the Kiribilli market tour, sort of. And then I did an IGTV, the haul of that trip to the Kiribilli markets. Okay, it's time to do the laundry.